Greetings, I am the cartoon hero. And, you know, I honestly can't believe it's taken me this long to get to a Shin Megami Tensei game. For those who don't know, the Shin Megami Tensei, or Mega Ten series, is a huge series of RPGs in Japan, spanning over 50 games since the first title, Digital Devil Story, in 1987, not even counting all of the re-releases and remakes, or all of the anime they spawned. Suffice to say that while it doesn't have quite the same following that Final Fantasy does, it's up there. The core of most of these games is the same. You play a character who, through a mixture of magic and science, has to befriend and command demons in order to fight other demons. Well, I say demons, but that's not really the right word. The Japanese word doesn't carry with it the same connotations that Christianity has with demons. A better word would really be monsters, because some demons are good and some are evil, which is not necessarily the same as the lawful, neutral, and chaotic categories every monster is divided into. For example, the Christian god Yahweh or Jehovah exists in some of these games. And while some of his angels are healers, they're also warriors. And it's implied that in the lawful ending of a lot of these games that God wants to create a utopia at the cost of free will. Which ironically sounds like what some fundamentalists believe. Depending on the choices you as a player make, it's usually easier to befriend or create demons of a certain alignment. Oh yeah, in most games you can create stronger demons by fusing them together, or spending currency to create them. As long as you have the right password and are at the right level. Think of it as Pokemon. With dicks. Lots and lots of dicks. Now, I don't have the time, and neither do you, to talk about each and every one of these games, but that's a good thing because I haven't even come close to playing them all. The ones I have played are mostly the handheld entries. For example, there's Devil Survivor 1 and 2, which follows a group of students during the apocalypse. It's kind of a tactical RPG like Fire Emblem, where each kid controls a small team of demons to attack with. The whole idea of being during the apocalypse carries over to a lot of the Mega Ten series, makes it a lot easier to include them when the demons are invading Earth. Such was also the case for Strange Journey, where you're a soldier trying to stop the demon realm from consuming the Earth, though it was more of a first-person dungeon crawler with random encounters. Same basic premise goes for Devil Summoner Soul Hackers, except the demons are invading through cyberspace and you're part of a gang of cyberpunk hackers trying to stop them. Soul hacking is a thing to do, and it doesn't hurt to have a low IQ. Then there's Shin Megami Tensei 4, the first numbered game in a while, where you play a samurai fighting demons in a medieval fantasy world, despite some futuristic tech. It's also a dungeon crawler, but you're in third person and the encounters aren't random. But I'm not here to review those games. I just thought I'd let you know what the games I played were like, and that even though at the core they're all RPGs with much the same cast of demons, though their abilities change between games, they presented in a different way each time. However, when Reviewers Unknown was sadly disbanded, a certain game was donated to me by Ozzy Arcane, a game that, while being a Mega Ten spin-off, is also part of its own series, Persona 4. Like I said before, I only have a PS2, so this is the only version of the game I can currently play, even if it hadn't been donated to me. I also got the entire PS2.hack series, so maybe I'll get to those one of these days. However, today we'll be looking at Persona 4 because a lot of people wanted me to review a Persona game, and let's see why this spin-off is a lot of people's favorite part of the series, including mine.